In this video, we will change a photo of a vase with sunflowers into a painting of Vincent van Gogh. The download link for the images is in the video description. When GIMP is open, we right-click somewhere in the window. Go to File, and then to Open. Search for your image and open it. Click on the zoom icon in the top right to maximize the image in the window. Hit the duplicate button at the bottom of the layers panel twice to make two duplicates. Press and hold the shift key and click on the eye of the bottom layer to make the other layers invisible. Then activate the bottom layer. Double click on the name and rename it Base. Hit enter. Now we go to filters in the menu bar, click on artistic and water pixels. It can take a moment depending on your system to see the effect. Then we change the super pixel size to 40. And again, we have to wait a moment for it to process. Check the option Split View. We can click and drag the line in the image to the left or to the right. In this way we can clearly see the effect. Uncheck the option again. And then we can click OK. Now we make the middle layer visible by clicking the eye and we make it active. Double click on the name and change it to Details. Hit Enter. Make the mode of this layer lighten only so we get some detail back. Reduce the opacity to about 50 or whatever looks good to you. We can turn this layer off and on to see the effect. Now we make the top layer visible and active. Double click on the name and rename it Lines. Hit enter. Back to filters and now we click on Edge Detect and then on Edge. Here we make the amount 1 and click OK. Go to Colors and click on Invert. We change the mode of this layer to Darken Only. Press and hold the Shift key and click on the eye of the base layer and make it active. In the toolbox we activate the Select by Color tool. At the mode we choose the second option which is Add to Current Selection. Now we select several different areas in the background. Make sure that you do not select the whole background but leave some areas unselected. Try to avoid selecting the flowers, the vase and the underground. With Ctrl Z we can undo one or more previous steps. Then we go to Filters, Distorts and hit Mosaic. Make the tile neatness 0,4 and click OK. Go to Select and click on None. To deselect the selection, press and hold the Shift key again and click once more on the eye of the bottom layer so all the layers become visible again. Make the top layer active. Press Ctrl Shift N to make a new layer. We name this layer Canvas. Make the mode Multiply and make the layer fill type white. Click OK. Now we go back to Filters and this time we click on Artistic and on Apply Canvas. We make the depth 8 and click OK. Now we are going to add a frame to our painting. Go to File, open as Layers and open the image of the frame. Go to Image and click Fit Canvas to Layers. Then zoom out by holding the Ctrl key down and rolling the mouse wheel until you can see the whole frame. Go back to the menu bar, click on Layers, Transform and then on Rotate 90 degrees clockwise. And again to Image and now to Fit Canvas to Layers. In the toolbox we activate the Scale tool and then we click in the image. To move the dialog box out of the way, we click on this icon. Now we can drag and drop it to wherever we want. Scale the frame so the painting fits nicely. When it looks okay, we click Scale. Right-click on the frame layer and hit Alpha to Selection, so everything in the frame layer that's not transparent is selected. Go to Select and hit Feather. Feather the selection with 3 pixels and click OK. Click on Edit and then on Stroke Selection. Make the line width 3 and click Stroke. In this way the transition between the painting and the frame looks more natural. Go to Select and hit None. And again to Image and now to Fit Canvas to Layers. And there we have our Van Gogh sunflowers. I hope you have fun with this video. Please give it a thumbs up and post a nice comment. I would appreciate it very much. Thank you for watching.